Asparagus is a green, white, or purple spike of a vegetable that heralds spring, goes well with eggs, and gives a really weird smell to your pee. Or maybe it doesn't. About 2 out of every 5 people don't seem to experience stinky asparagus pee, either because they don't make it, or they can't smell it, or both. Great minds have pondered this smelly mystery since at least 1731, when a Scottish physician noticed that eating asparagus gave urine a definite funk. But nearly 300 years later, we still don't totally understand this stink, partly because it isn't a particularly high priority research area, and partly because, despite centuries of scientific and technological progress, the gold standard for this research field still seems to involve sniffing pee. Pee sniffing has helped scientists figure out the basics, though. In a 2010 study, researchers collected pee from people both after they ate asparagus and after they ate bread, then invited the urinators back to sniff everyone's creations. Some people declined to return, perhaps because of what the researchers called an unanticipated aversion to urine. Of the participants that did agree to sniff, a few couldn't distinguish the samples of asparagus pee from their bread pee counterparts, which suggests that some people just can't smell asparagus funk. We don't know exactly why yet, but variation in a set of olfactory receptor genes may be what separates the asparagus pee smellers from the non-smellers. What's more, a few people in the study produced asparagus and bread pee samples that were indistinguishable to everyone, suggesting that some people don't make stinky asparagus pee. But here's where pee sniffing falls short, because it's also possible that something even stinkier in those samples masked the asparagus odor. To figure out what's causing the stink, researchers turned to scientific sniffing and found 5 sulfur-containing compounds that were up to thousands of times more abundant in the air above the stinky pee than above the non-stinky pee. These may be produced when an asparagus-specific molecule called asparagusic acid, or is it asparagusic? Asparagesic? Anyway, when this acid breaks down in the body. But that doesn't explain why some people get stinky pee and others don't. Perhaps stinky peers, or their gut microbes, metabolize that molecule differently than their less funky counterparts. Maybe in the next 300 years, scientists will solve this peculiar mystery. But until then, there's lots of asparagus to be eaten and pee to be sniffed. It's for science, people! Hi, this is Kate from MinuteEarth. If you're as curious about this subject as we are, stay tuned to help us do a little research of our own. But first, we want to give a big thanks to Blue Apron for sponsoring this video. Blue Apron meal kits show up at your door with perfectly portioned ingredients plus recipes for making healthy meals in 40 minutes or less, so you don't need to stress about what to cook for dinner or spend time at the grocery store. I recently tried a Blue Apron delivery and love the super fresh and unique ingredients, like pink lemons and pea tips. Check out the link in the video description for a 2-meal discount on your first Blue Apron order. And speaking of fresh vegetables, please take our 3-minute survey to let us know about your asparagus behavior. The link is in the description below. We'll compile the results and in a few weeks share them with scientists and with you via Twitter and Facebook. Thanks! Your participation could help solve the mystery.